what's going to contribute to the stress? Let me first, let me draw what we're looking at. Okay, so the beam continues like this, but we're looking at the midpoint. So we're looking at this cross section, and we're looking at this line on that cross section. Okay, so any one of these points, that's what we're representing. What internal loads are going to contribute to the stress on this line? So there's three internal loads: tension, shear force, and bending moment. Which ones are going to contribute here? Just the shear force and then the tension also. Okay, so that tension that you calculate is going to act at any point on the cross section. So the shear force, you don't have to worry about the bending moment, but we are going to have to worry about that tension. So let's do a cut. I mean, you can do it from the left, then you have to calculate the reaction force at the wall. Let's do a cut from the right. So then your free body diagram looks like this. Over here, all you have is this 20,000 Newton force to the left. You have a weight force coming down. It's a distributed load of 9810x, right? Rx is 0.5, so the point force here is 4905. And then we have a tension, a shear force. I drew that shear force upside down. So since we're working from the right, that shear force has to be up. And we have a bending moment like this. And we don't have to worry about calculating that bending moment because we know that there's not going to be any normal stress due to bending moment on that line. Newton's second law says negative T0 plus 0V plus 20,000 0 plus 0 negative 4905 is equal to 0. So you get a tension of 20,000 and a shear force of positive 4905. This is all we need to calculate the stress tensor at this point. So let's calculate some of those mathematical values that we're going to need to calculate these stresses. So first, the area is equal to pi r squared. So what do you get for that? What is that as a decimal? Okay. I is equal to pi times 0.2 to the fourth divided by 4. What do you get for that one? 1.2. Q is equal to 2 times 0.2 cubed. Over 3, what's that one? 0.003. Okay, and then B? Right, yep. So that's going to be 0.4. All right, so due to the tension, we're going to have an XX stress of our tension value is positive 20,000 divided by the area, 0.125. So what do you get for stress XX? Okay. And then due to shear force, tau XY, is it going to be positive or negative? Yeah, so we have a positive shear force, so that's coming down the positive X face. And so on the positive X face, that's a negative Y shear. So we have a negative value times the magnitude of the shear force, so 4905, times Q, 0.0053, divided by I, 257 times 10 to the minus third, and then B, 0.4, and what do you get for tau XY? So negative 5.2 times 10 to the 4. And so now we can put that together, and the total stress tensor is equal to 1.6 times 10 to the 5th, negative 5.2 times 10 to the 4th, negative 5.2 times 10 to the 4th, and everything else zeros. So on a stress cube, we have a tension of 1.6 times 10 to the 5th. What direction is the shear force? Up or down? Down, yep. So that's 5.2 times 10 to the 4th, and then it has to be that way and that way. And so what is the deformation going to look like? So you're going to go from this. Yep, it's going to get more obtuse here. And it's going to stretch out along the x-axis, thin out along the y-axis, and along the z-axis. That's just not shown here. And so now due to the shear, this is going to get more obtuse, so it's going to look something like this.
When you did your, when you changed it going from the right, did you still get the same answer as going from the left?
Yeah. You got different answers?
No, I didn't.
Oh, yeah. Yep. Any questions about that? Other questions? Okay, that's it.